So I want to make a video on how I make art in Photoshop, but who the fuck uses Photoshop anymore? Here's a new video on how I make shit in Clip Studio. This whole video is gonna be on Clip Studio, no other programs. And even though I'm using an iPad, don't worry, cause like the whole app is exactly the same as on PC. I'm also using a Bluetooth keyboard, so I'll be using shortcuts and stuff as well. Now open this bitch up. Make a new file. I usually start with a 3K by 3K canvas. The resolution is 300 dpi. Hit OK. And immediately change the background to gray because you're gonna get blinded. Now, this is how I set up my whole workspace if I were on a PC, which is, oh shit. On the right here, you have the navigator so you can see what you're doing, your colors, your layers, then your brushes and settings for the brush. But if you're using an iPad like me, my workspace is color, brush, and layers. The rest, navigators and other brushes, are on another panel, but they're hidden because the screen is so small and it's hard to work on, but it works. It just works. Also, here's a little thing. Whenever you draw and you see that little star beside the name of your canvas, it means that, hey, remember to save. There's a save button right there. Make sure to click it before you stop and do anything else. Don't lose your files and stuff. Especially if you're on an iPad, don't switch apps and stuff before saving, because it will just close itself and might not recover. Sometimes it recovers, sometimes it says fuck you, and you lose all that progress. So make sure to save your shit. Let's start with the art. I don't really use any other brushes that are downloaded. I just use the default. I used to use this one that was downloaded. I'll put a link in the description. But I don't use it anymore. I'm just back to default stuff. I use the brush, not the pens. I use the brush for sketching. Transparent watercolor. And just, you know, play with the settings a bit. I don't know. I can't explain this. This is too difficult. It's so much. Just learn it. Just play around until you learn it yourself. It's so much. So for this video, I'm going to draw my original character. Because why not? In the profile view, because that's easy. You only have to draw one eye. And here's a little proportion tip. You draw a circle, and in the middle of the circle, that's where your ear is gonna go. You draw the face, chin, so see, the chin, the jaw, goes to the middle. And also the back of the scalp? It ends just right in the center. Well, not exactly center, a bit lower, so that's where it goes. Then you curve, neck, there you go. Where the ear starts, that's where the eyes are. At the bottom, that's where the nose ends. I want her to look down a bit, so press L on your keyboard. That's for lasso. Once you get that, this button is for transform. Personally, I don't like using the eraser. I just hit C to switch the color to transparency and use that as an eraser instead. Shit, this is Mac. Okay, so if I say Command, that means Control for Windows. If I say Options, that means Alt for Windows. I'm an Apple hoe, so I'm gonna go with the Mac. If you hold Option and Command at the same time and drag, you can use that to change your brush size. Now, sketch is done. You don't stop right there, you do another sketch. Lower the opacity. Create a new layer with this button and sketch again. So here's something I saw on Twitter. Make a new layer, go to your layer properties, hit the circle one. This is a border effect. And see, whatever I draw has an outline. Gonna increase the thickness. And you can pretty much just use this to block out areas of the hair. I'm gonna make another one and do that border thing again. So now there's another layer of hair. And I can sketch over this as well. Gonna merge them with this button here. Now for line art. Lower opacity. Lock the layer so I don't accidentally, you know, move it around when I'm trying to do my goddamn line art. So time for line art. The most tiring process of this. I use the regular G-Pen. Sometimes I use this one, it's called Real G-Pen.
and it has like a really nice textury effect to it, to the lines, and it's really nice. But for this video, I'm going to show you this one, which is, it looks like this, the regular G-Pen, but look at this.
It's got a really weird shape to it. See that little button next to brush size? Hit it.
This is the settings for pen pressure. Usually it's like that, and that is terrible for line art.
But since the one that I discovered was really obnoxiously thick and thin while drawing, it's really fun. So hit 2 points, one in the center of that box, one center here, and move it down to the box below here, into the center.
And that's how I got my weird pen pressure pen thing. Shit, I forgot. I'm not gonna use a regular ass layer. We're gonna go to the layer on the top, new layer, and vector layer. Because doing line art with vector layer is so much easier. If you hold command and you click on it, you can see like the little anchor points. This is a vector.
Here's a neat trick.
Say you do the thing like, yeah, and then you cut. And then usually you would go like, oh, just gotta slowly erase each of these. No! You go to your eraser, hit vector eraser, and it's the middle one. Yep, that one. And then you just boop. And there, look at that. That saves so much time. And now you just fucking go on your line art. If something like this happens, where you want to delete this line, but it's not, it looks like it's connected, but not. Just, you know, select this. And I just yeet a couple of anchors out. Now I can delete it. So line art, done. Gonna rasterize it, cause there's no point in having it as a vector anymore. Right click on your layer or hold, press and hold for iPad and rasterize. Now fill in like little bits of parts like underneath the chin on the neck, fill that in.
Also add like very minimal shading. So I'm about to start coloring, but before that, I need to mask her whole area. Go to wand tool and pick area scaling. If it's at zero, the selection will be right at the edge of the line art. If I add a bit more, like three pixels, it'll take in the line art. So make sure you do this. If not, when you start coloring, it's just gonna have like a little white outline. It's like, fuck. So like three is, it depends on the width of your line art. Usually 2 or 3 is good. So select the background parts that isn't her. So between the hair. Done. Hit this triangle half-half thing, it'll invert your selection. Now, my character is selected. Make a new layer beneath, and hit that circle square thing, that's called mask. You can test this out by just pick a random color and hit the paint bucket tool on the top, that's for filling. You know, just go around and check and make sure like all the places and areas are selected. Maybe there's some that's still not, maybe there's areas that's like maybe too much. See that little dot there? You select your mask and then color it in. And we're gonna start coloring. Instead of just coloring, gonna use the paint bucket and pick refer multiple and pick this one. Back to your color layer. Pick your color, make sure area scaling is up because don't want that thin line. And what happens is you can just start filling in the colors.
And done, kind of. There's little gaps that you have to like go in and color it yourself. Like the program isn't gonna do everything for you. So you still gotta fix up some places yourself.
You can check to see if you've gotten everything by toggling the visibility on your line art. And you can see there's a bunch of gaps that hasn't been colored in because of the paint bucket. If you have your line art up and it doesn't show, then that's fine, but sometimes it just, you know, like little things like that. So you just gotta, yep.
Why does my original character have red eyes? I made her when I was 15. Don't question this. When you're 15, you make all the cringy stuff. And when you're 18, you hate it. And when you're 20, you're like, shit. Bring back those memories, please. I don't like that line. That line looks weird. Go back to my line art and take that out. Yeah, that's better. What? Whoa, what is that? What is that? Like, the more you zoom in, the more weird shit you find. That just, where did this come from? And just pray that as long as nobody zooms in on my art, no one can see my mistakes. Color flats. Done. New layer on top. Change it to multiply. And just pick any color. And this button right here is for clipping. It'll clip whatever in this layer will apply to the layer below. So it is now clipped to my colors layer. How do you shade? Where's the light source? Where is the light source? I don't know. It's just me, like, waddling around saying I'm an artist, even though I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing. I'm gonna switch over to the line art brush, because I need sharper lines to shade this hair. Now hit lock transparency and change the line art color. Not the line art color, why did I say line art color? I meant the shading color, yeah. But if this is like, oh no, I gotta zoom in and slowly like paint in, like, you can just go to your color, hit the wand tool, and take off refer multiple, because we're only gonna select the stuff that's on the color layer. So I'm gonna select her hair. And I see that it also selected like parts of her collar. That means I gotta change the color margin. There's parts like her eyebrow, this little part here. Oh, it's already selected. Back to your shading layer. And I want the shade to be this bluish color. Then hit the paint bucket icon on the top and it'll fill all the shade for her hair to blue. And repeat process until you're done. Your shading is done. Now if you hit the button next to merge layer, this one, it'll put anything that's on this layer to the one below. So now these layers are now merged, but it kept the original layer. So this is now an empty layer. It's an empty multiply layer, and I'm gonna do more shading on it, like little blush. I use this one, it's called emphasizing texture. Put down the hardness and it's just pretty much an airbrush. Merge that again. Gonna do more shading. So now your other shading's done. Just merge them. If you press the merge layer and this comes up, you can either apply the mask or keep the mask in case you want to do like other stuff. But I don't have any use for the mask anymore, so I'm just gonna hit apply. And the mask is gone, but the layer is now its own thing in all its glory. Time for line art color change. Lock the transparency, start changing the color. It's done, complete. You could stop right here or keep going. Now merge those layers because you do not fear God. Got a new layer, and this is for itty bitty details just to make it pop. Now for hair highlights, I'm gonna make a new layer and I'm gonna show you how I do this thing because I got it from other artists, how they do it. Pick like a brush, a brushy watercolor brush. That one looks good, smooth watercolor. Once you've done that, you change to transparent and just start near the middle and then stroke outwards. same with the other side. And it's gonna make a little shiny effect. Maybe change the layer to glow. That's glowing. And then just keep cleaning up. Since it's an add glow layer, if I merge it with the layer below, which was just the details, it's not gonna stick because nothing's there. I'm just gonna keep it for now and go back to the details and just keep going. For clothing, I like to add the stitching on the edges of the cloth of the shirt. And so yeah, just go to this brush right here. It's the one with all the patterns and stuff. Go to the ruled lines and there should be one called dashed line. So this here is neat. You just, increase size. Just adding this little detail just makes it look really nice. Why is she wearing a collar? Aesthetic, bitch. Now that looks pretty cool. So see, before adding details and after, it just looks a little bit better and less boring. I'm gonna merge this. Gonna merge this one as well. Yeah, it sticks. And new layer, multiply. This is for airbrush. Yeah, just giving a little more gradient color on the hair. Maybe a bit on the shirt. There, that looks cool. What about the background? I don't know. To bright red. Oh no, this is repeating itself. This is like history repeating itself. For the Photoshop video, I also went with like bright red background. And for this, I'm also going with the bright reddish pink background. Listen, it matches her eyes, okay? I'm gonna crop. Go to edit and change canvas size. I wanna crop right here. Yep, you have to make the sacrifice just for composition. Like you spent so much time drawing on that part and then, well, it's gonna be cropped out, so. I remembered I wanted to add a glow to her eyes. And now you're done. But wait, there's more. Duplicate your layer just in case you mess up. It's Command J. Gonna hide this one. I'm gonna play around with the colors on this one. Go to edit, tonal correction, and color balance. And just go wild. Now you see the difference between before and after. The weirder it gets, the more interesting it looks. But problem, all the details on her eyes have disappeared, so I have to paint over this again. So here's another thing you could do. You duplicate it and go to tonal correction and go to curves. Tone curve. Change to red, then you make some anchor points, several anchor points, then go up and down. Make a wave. Add more points, make more waves. Do it with green and blue as well, but not on RGB. I think I forgot to mention this, like when you're doing the pen pressure curve thing like this and you made an anchor point and you want to delete it. I was an idiot. I didn't know how you do it. You just drag it out off screen and it's gone. I had to ask Twitter how to do it. So this here looks a bit creepy. It looks a bit like 90s anime-ish, but this is how those artists make those holographic effect. Just lower the opacity to like keep it either on normal or like some other, just keep going and playing around with it. You can make it look pretty damn interesting. So you see that? It changes the color. There's a gradient somehow. It looks pretty fucking cool. I'm gonna add more things. Here's a brush called Battlefield Dust. Link in the description. It's like she's been in an anime fight. Now, texture, new layer, filter, render, noise, and the scale to the smallest. That's too small. Give yourself a nice TV screen. press OK, and change the layer to overlay. Then there's your lovely texture, but that is too much. Please decrease it. Down to 14 is good. 14, 15, about 10, 20 is enough. So this is pretty much done. Though I forgot one detail. I forgot the earrings. Fuck. Okay, now I'm really done with details. Okay, I keep adding stuff. Don't forget to sign your art. I recommend writing out your username instead of using a, you know, signature. Because this way, if people repost it, they can find you if they look up your name on Google. Oh yeah, here's a thing I see people do. So what you do is create a new layer, set it to overlay, and then use a blurred brush and pick maybe orange and stroke around the edges of where the shadows are. I forgot what this effect is called, but it makes it look pretty cool. So one teeny tiny final adjustment I like to do is to liquify, but Clip Studio doesn't have liquify. If it did, it'd be so much better. So the closest thing would be mesh transformation. Go to edit, transform, mesh transformation, which is the warp thing in Photoshop, and shift everything around so it doesn't look too squished or weird. It's just a very teeny tiny correction, kind of. Like before, I think it looks a bit stretched out because I draw weirdly, and now it looks a bit better. Now it's complete. It's really, really complete. For real now. Ready for export. Now give yourself a pat on the back because you just finished one piece of art. Am I talking to you? No, I'm talking to myself. So if you like this video, don't subscribe because I rarely make any videos. Instead, just give it a like and go follow my Twitter, Instagram. If you really like my art, drop me a dollar on Patreon. Hell yeah, you'll get, you know, art. That's it. Or $5 for like shit sent to your house. Okay, that's it. I'm done. Bye.